Okay, here on the left and the right, you can see our two frequency domain telegrapher's equations or transmission line equations, one for voltage and the other for current. The thing to observe here is that the voltage is generating the current and the current is generating the voltage. Any time that omega would be zero, this wouldn't happen. But in this case, where omega is non-zero, we have to actually use both of these equations together simultaneously in order to be able to solve any of our transmission line equations. That another way to say this is that we have two coupled differential equations. They are both first order differential equations. See, here's the first order right there. Also, you can see that the j omega is first order right here. So we have two first order coupled differential equations. Both have to be solved simultaneously together in order to find the voltage and the current on a transmission line. But there's another really nice equation called the wave equation that gives us a single equation for which we can solve for voltage and current. And this is how we derive it. We take either of these transmission line equations, telegrapher's equations, and we take its derivative with respect to z, such as this one. And then we substitute that back into the other telegrapher's equations. So let's do that. This is going to give us a second derivative on this side is equal to r prime plus j omega l prime. These are constants, so the derivative with respect to z only comes over here and attaches itself to the current term. And then we're going to solve for this and substitute it in here to this equation. So what that's going to give us, let's just kind of do this, the derivative of I with respect to z is equal to the second derivative of v divided by r prime plus j omega l prime. So again, substitute that back in here, and that's going to give us, the two negatives will cancel out, so we'll have second derivative of v in space is equal to r prime plus j omega l prime times g prime plus j omega c prime, that term right there, times v. Now what do you suppose would have happened if we had done it the opposite way, where we took the derivative of the current equation and substituted it back into v? What we would have gotten, actually, let me be sure I've got my pluses and my minuses right. Yep, just like this. The other term that we would have gotten is the second derivative of the current is equal to r prime plus j omega l prime g prime plus j omega c prime times I. Now this term right here, is a special thing. That is the propagation constant, we call it gamma, propagation constant squared. This is the complex propagation constant, and it is squared. The way we can write that is the complex propagation constant is alpha plus j beta. Now you've already seen alpha and beta. Beta was the real propagation constant. And what was alpha? Alpha was the attenuation constant. Alpha is given in nepers per meter, and beta is given in radians per meter.